This is a low-quality render of a villa in the desert. So in this video, we're gonna change that and turn it into something like this. Okay, let's begin. First of all, I'm going to change the sky. I'm selecting the sky. Then I'm creating a copy of my sky by using Ctrl J. Then I'm bringing a beautiful cloudy sky into my picture. And I'm creating a clipping mask. I also want to add a line of trees behind my villa. I've already cut out the sky from this picture, so I'm bringing these trees and put them here. I'm creating a clipping mask and I'm making these three layers into one group. I'm selecting the background picture again and I'm using my pen tool to select the ground. And I'm using this picture to cover my ground with grass. Then on this layer, I'm creating a clipping mask. And I'm changing the blending mode to linear light. Then I'm creating a group of these layers and name it ground. Now we need a clean selection of the villa without the windows. I'm putting it here. And I want to add this texture to the villa. So I'm creating a clipping mask again, and as you can see, it covers all the surfaces of the villa. I'm using multiply as its blending mode, and I'm decreasing the opacity. I'm creating a group of these layers and call it villa. Then I'm bringing the windows I cut out before and put it here. Then I'm bringing this picture as my reflection on the windows. And then I'm creating a clipping mask on this layer and change its blending mode to linear light. Decrease the opacity to 15%. Then I'm creating a group of these layers and then I want to add some trees around the villa. Okay, after I added the trees, I'm using my brush tool to make my feather trees look darker. Then I'm creating a clipping mask and I'm using overlay as my blending mode. So for the last touches, I'm adding some flying birds on the sky. And then I'm creating a flat image of all the edits I've done so far by using Ctrl Alt Shift and E. Then I'm going to filter and I'm clicking on camera raw filter. Okay, here on these settings, I'm increasing the texture, I'm increasing the clarity. On details section, I'm increasing sharpening amount. On optics section, I'm increasing the distortion to 5. And for the last part on calibration, I'm decreasing the saturation of the green, red, and blue. And click OK. And let's take a look at it before and after. Now I can say I'm pretty satisfied with the result. If you like this video as well, please hit subscribe to my YouTube channel and I will be back with more videos like this. Have a great day.